Welcome back. We are joined by the stalwarts of the Indian Express, Deeptiman Tiwari with me, and of course my colleague Parveen Dogra, who had done an extensive ground report on Haryana ahead of the polls. Deeptiman sir, Haryana 90 by 90, early trends in, we'll wrap up in some time, the counting will wrap up. What do you think about the numbers?
Well, extraordinary, because almost anyone who went to Haryana came back saying that Congress is winning, and not just winning, but winning big. And from there to retain power after 10 years of anti-incumbency, remarkable achievement by the BJP leadership, both at the state and at the center, the way they have managed the elections. And why I'm saying they have managed the elections, because they have literally managed these elections. It's not something that there was a, you know, popular wave in favor of the BJP. It was not visible, but they have literally managed these elections, and it goes to the credit of the BJP and their massive election machinery, that the way they're able to snatch victory out of the jaws of defeat, and almost the contrary can be said of the Congress, to snatch defeat from the jaws of victory. Let's remember, in these elections, why I'm saying they have managed, there was considerable anger among the Jats against the BJP, not just now, but for probably 10 years, because, you know, Haryana for the longest time has only seen Jat-dominated politics. Jats form around 27% of voters in Haryana. And if you look at the history of barring one or two, all chief ministers have been Jats,
right,
in Haryana.
Right.
So it has been a Jat-dominated politics, and Jats were kept out of politics for 10 years by this coalition of Panthis Biradari that BJP had cobbled up.
Correct.
And this had riled up the Jats for quite some time, and yet the Congress, despite projecting a Jat as, you know, although they did not officially name a CM, but everybody knew that Hooda is being projected as the chief ministerial candidate, and it is Hooda who picked all the tickets. I mean, 70 of the 90 tickets,
right,
have been distributed by Hooda. So Hooda's writ was large over this election. So this was actually a Jat face versus an OBC face election. And yet the Congress has not done as well in the Jat in central Haryana. The kind of traction they were supposed to get in central Haryana in the Jat dominated seats, they have not done well as per expectations, and that is where they have lost the elections.
Deeptiman, you know, you used a very interesting phrase, snatching loss from the jaws of victory for Congress. And in a very weird way, I cannot help but draw this parallelism when it comes to BJP versus Congress head-on fights that we saw in 2024 elections also. Why does it become like an India-Australia in the finals kind of a thing, that Congress falls flat? Because in Haryana, the anti-incumbency wave was huge.
देखिए, Congress के साथ वही हुआ है जो 2024 में BJP के साथ हुआ था. This is Congress's 400 पार moment. You are so confident of winning this election that you're not even putting the kind of effort that is required on the ground. You have taken it for granted. Okay, this is the only party which is not talking about winning the election. It is talking about who will be the CM.
Yes.
They have gone two steps
the,
ahead.
The debate is Kumari Sailja is projecting herself, then Hooda is projecting himself, then there is Uday Bhan who is projecting himself. So everybody is talking about who will be the next CM of Haryana from Congress, rather than whether Congress will win the election or not in the first place. So this is a 400 par moment for the Congress, and that is what has led to their defeat. Let's also remember, BJP, of course, resources matter. BJP has, I think, some more than close to around 150 rallies in Haryana.
Yes, yes.
Compared to Congress is just about 70-75.
Right.
So a party which is incumbent, which is facing anti-incumbency, has put, look at the kind of effort they have put. Also, there is a lot of election engineering which has happened. Just the sheer number of independents in these elections in Haryana, especially in the belts that BJP was expecting to lose.
Right.
So people will obviously speculate that these independents were in a major way propped up by the BJP. Of course, BJP has the resources. It is running the union government. It is the incumbent government in Haryana, so it has the resources. Just the sheer number of independents. Look, Haryana is a small state. Margins of defeat can be between 2,000 to 5,000.
Still, the margin between trailing and leading candidate is just within 1,000 votes.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So, with such small margins, when you have too many independents, तब एक independent 1,000-2,000 vote भी काट ले जाए, तो game हो जाता है.
Dithiban, we are joined by Manraj, our resident editor from Chandigarh. Manraj, do you agree to Dithiban that this is Congress's 400 par moment happening right now?
Yes. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, and Deepthiman is right. BJP. I agree with Deepthiman. BJP has been very, very strategic and tactical. So it did not give up till the very last minute, and it started planning way before Congress did. So while Congress was still squabbling, and also in the middle, it started celebrating too soon. BJP continued. So what they did was right. I think before the Lok Sabha elections, they sent out these raths to every village documenting their social welfare schemes. So every village would have this LCD screen telling you which are the schemes that you benefit from and who all are eligible for the schemes. And just in case you aren't getting this dole or whatever, or this benefit that you're supposed to get, please register. We are here for you. We are at your doorstep. So I guess a lot of people, especially the underprivileged people, got benefited from it. And we did not really go out. We went to, the media, the exit polls, etc. Went to all these chaupals where you have a lot of people sitting and playing cards, etc. And the information that you got from them was only of a certain segment, and which was mainly the land owning jats. So if you see the results, Congress has fared very well in the jat seats. They have taken the jat seats, but all the GT road segment, the 25 seats on the GT road, the Ahirwal belt, those are completely with the BJP. So as he said, BJP worked very hard and it had a plan in place. It had done its arithmetic, so it did not depend on emotions as much as it did on just the numbers. There is how the numbers stack up. And right at the beginning, when the independents were filing and the last date of withdrawal came and nobody withdrew, that is the time we did sit up and think that why are there so many independents? I mean, who is behind them? And the fact that all these are anti-BJP votes, which they will fetch, and they will eat into Congress votes, which is what has happened.